What a Feeling and the Panasonic Viera.
In 1969, when I won the Brownlow Medal, it certainly changed my life forever to be recognised as a Brownlow medalist with the late Hayden Bunton Sr., Bobby Skilton, Ian Stewart and Dick Reynolds. It was a privilege to be acknowledged with those men.
It is rare that we can pinpoint dramatic change in life. But we know that the events of tonight will echo throughout a lifetime and beyond. No matter what becomes of a man, no matter what good or bad fortune he endures, no matter what wise or poor decisions he makes, no matter what happens in the world, once a man joins this elite group, he will always be known as a Brownlow medalist. Tonight, another chapter will be penned in this medal's unique storybook. So with history calling, we await another name, the next Brownlow medalist. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome your host for the 2004 Brownlow Medal Count, Stephen Quatermain.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's great to be back again. On behalf of Network 10 and the AFL, welcome to the Palladium at Crown for the 2004 Brownlow Medal. We've seen all the glitz and glamour earlier with the red carpet arrivals. Now it's time to find out who is the best and fairest player in the AFL as adjudged by the umpires. Will tonight mark the start of a historic week for Port Adelaide? Can the favourite, Warren Treadray, become the Power's first Brownlow medalist and then lead his team to their first ever premiership on Saturday? Yes, says Mark Williams. Or will St Kilda's glamour boy, Nick Riewoldt, at the ripe old age of just 21, cap off a magnificent season? Can another 21-year-old young gun, Chris Judd from the West Coast Eagles, snare the prize? Or will Brisbane's Nigel Lappin complete a Lions quadrilla and become the last member of the original Fab Four to win football's biggest individual honour? Of course, the Fab Four is now the Fab Five, as we say hello to Luke Power up in Brisbane also. Other names in with a chance of winning the Brownlow this year include previous winners in Mark Rusciutto and Simon Black. There's Jeff White, Cameron Ling, Chad Corns, Scott West and Barry Hall, just to name a few. So good luck to all those in the running tonight for the Brownlow for 2004. Also, best of luck to the two teams playing for the flag on Saturday at the MCG. Congratulations to Mark Williams and the Port Adelaide team for making their first ever grand final. An exciting week for everyone at the Power. And they've got a function over there in Port Adelaide Heartland tonight. Good luck, Mark. And good luck to Lee Matthews and his team up at the Gabba tonight in Queensland. The Lions out to equal history by winning four premierships in a row. What an extraordinary achievement that would be. So good luck once again to the Lions and to the Power and to Mark and Lee. Well done, guys. As always, the votes for the Brownlow Medal are kept under lock and key until now. Like us tonight, they have arrived on the red carpet as we bring them into the room and into the safe hands of the AFL. All the envelopes containing the votes have today been accounted for by the AFL's auditors, KPMG, and Main Logistics, which provides the security. As the votes come onto the stage, may I also take this opportunity to thank our hosts for tonight, Crown, to Joe Stuckey and all the team at Crown. Thank you very much. Yes, indeed. You always put on a great show. It's also a big night for the Chief Executive Officer of the AFL, Andrew Demetriou. He is making his Brownlow Medal vote counting debut and he has been practicing religiously over many, many weeks. Where is Andrew down here? And he's nailed all the dodgy names at rehearsal, so he's rearing to go. So let's officially start proceedings. And welcome, put your hands together for the CEO of the AFL, Andrew Demetriou.
Thank you, Stephen. Tonight's gathering is a properly constituted meeting of the AFL with all commissioners present, except for Chris Langford, who is an apology. In accordance with AFL Rule 19, at the conclusion of each match, the three field umpires conferred and recorded their idea of the three fairest and best players in each of the 176 home and away matches played this season. The votes were then sealed in an envelope marked Brownlow Medal. In the case of two or more players receiving an equal number of votes, each shall be declared the joint winner, and each of these players shall be awarded a Brownlow Medal. Any player who has been found guilty of an offence in a home and away match, except for a time-wasting offence, shall be ineligible to win the Brownlow Medal. With me on stage will be Adrian Anderson, the General Manager of Football Operations, and from our Football Operations team, Dean Moore, Jill Lindsay, and Rod Austin. Thank you, Stephen.
Thanks, Andrew. So no mucking around, let's get straight into it. Time now to welcome my fellow Network 10 commentators, Tim Lane and Anthony Hudson. They will be taking us right through all the action, round by round, live. Good evening, gentlemen.
Evening, Steve.
Good evening, Cordes.
You've been through the Brownlow votes more than most for this count, so who do you like?
I'll go for a shock, Warren Treadray. And when in doubt, go for a blonde, Nick Riewoldt.
Exactly. Well, good luck, guys. Time now to start the count for 2004. And we start at the beginning, round one, back in the last week of March.
Umpires.
And Tim, everyone was getting on as the year began with the harmony round.
Hutto, there was even harmony at Punt Road as Rich Owen recruit Nathan Brown produced a promising double act with 20 marks and 7 goals between them.
Early form, though, would later prove a little unreliable. Hawthorn thrashed Melbourne. Shane Crawford had 32 touches. Another medalist, Simon Black, had 29 to get the Lions over the line against the Swans in a thriller.
What a heartbreaking end to Jason Ball's 150th, kicking it away in the last seconds. Ashley Sampy, though, kicked the Eagles home against the Bulldogs at Telstra Dome.
But it wasn't without controversy. The umpires later admitting Stephen Coops should have been paid this decision in the dying moments. And the controversy king, Wayne Carey, was the centre of attention again, getting reported in the Crows' loss to the Roos in round one.
Round one, Richmond versus Collingwood. Richmond, K. Johnson, one vote. Richmond, M. Richardson, two votes. Richmond, N. Brown, three votes. Hawthorn versus Melbourne. Melbourne, A. Uze, one vote. Hawthorn, S. Crawford, two votes. Hawthorn, R. Vandenberg, three votes. Fremantle versus Carlton. Fremantle, A. Sanderlands, one vote. Fremantle, B. Shammer, two votes. Fremantle, P. Bell, three votes. Brisbane versus Sydney. Sydney, A. Goods, one vote. Brisbane, S. Black, two votes. Sydney, P. Williams, three votes. St. Kilda versus Geelong. St. Kilda, A. Thompson, one vote. St. Kilda, F. Gehrig, two votes. St Kilda, A. Jones, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Essendon. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, one vote. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, two votes. Port Adelaide, P. Burgoyne, three votes. Kangaroos versus Adelaide. Kangaroos, S. Grant, one vote. Kangaroos, T. Makepeace, two votes. Kangaroos, L. Brown, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus West Coast Eagles. Western Bulldogs, J. Rawlings, one vote. West Coast, B. Cousins, 2 votes. West Coast, C. Judd, 3 votes.
Off-field drama in round two as Carlton sacked Lawrence Angwin and suspended Carl Norman for breaking the code of conduct.
Matthew Lloyd appeared to break the on-ground code, but a successful appeal against the two-match suspension meant he was free to play the following week.
As was James Hurd, despite putting the brakes on St Kilda's Andrew Thompson as the Saints scored a great win. A Brownlow medalist in the spotlight for the best of reasons was Michael Voss.
Yes, Voss kicked 7 goals as the Lions destroyed Adelaide and sent a message to those that had written him off as a false. Where is Mike Sheehan?
Yes, here we hear, but woes for last year's other grand finalist, Tom Davidson, facing the trauma of a second knee reconstruction, the low light of round two.
Round two, Melbourne versus Richmond. Melbourne, N. Brown, 1 vote. Melbourne, A. Uze, 2 votes. Melbourne, D. Neitz, 3 votes. Collingwood versus Western Bulldogs. Collingwood, N. Buckley, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, B. Johnson, 2 votes. Collingwood, J. Fraser, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Brisbane. Brisbane, T. Notting, 1 vote. Brisbane, C. Johnson, 2 votes. Brisbane, M. Voss, 3 votes. West Coast Eagles versus Port Adelaide. West Coast, A. Sampi, 1 vote. West Coast, C. Judd, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, 3 votes. Essendon versus St Kilda. St Kilda, F. Gehrig, 1 vote. Essendon, J. Hurd, 2 votes. St Kilda, L. Ball, 3 votes. Sydney versus Fremantle. Sydney, B. Matthews, 1 vote. Sydney, S. Maxfield, 2 votes. Sydney, B. Hall, 3 votes. Carlton versus Geelong. Carlton, R. Houlihan, 1 vote. Carlton, H. Scotland, 2 votes. Carlton, S. Camporeale, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, 1 vote. Kangaroos, L. Colbert, 2 votes. Kangaroos, S. Grant, 3 votes.
So a few of the big names already, a few of the big fancies already polling well, which is great to see, including Chris Judd, who at the moment is doing well with 5 votes. 2 rounds down, 20 to go. This is the Brownlow Medal Count for 2004.
Yes, the 2004 Brownlow Medal Count is underway, and Rob, looking forward to a great night. Our job tonight is to have a look at the leaders and just try and work out where they might poll their votes. And the two favourites off to a great start. Let's take a look at Warren Treadray to start with, and gee, 5 votes already.
Well, that's right, and as we look at that, Warren Treadray, 2 votes in the opening round, then 3 in round 2. The blocks in orange are where we predict Warren Treadray will get votes as the season goes on. You can see plenty of votes early and plenty towards the end.
Well, so with Chris Judd, off to another flying start. He's also got 5 votes, so fantastic performance. Back shortly, there was plenty of glitz.
Oh, it was just a big surprise, yeah. Last thing I expected, to be honest. I was just sitting there, got up, and next thing you know, yeah, as I said, he's just right there in front of me.
We were watching the ball, actually, and all of a sudden I said to Drew, oh, I think James is looking at us, and Drew's like, I think he's actually running to us. I'm like, quickly, stand up, stand up.
James, you are a
genius. He gave me a big come on, just a bit of a sigh of relief, I think, after kicking the goal and hopefully being the match-winning goal.
That's what footy's all about, you know. It's just a great game. So passionate about it.
I thought, oh, may as well get our 15 minutes of fame, so I called up 3AW and spoke about it, and yeah, I think I was screaming so much, I don't think they understood me.
And he's given an Essendon supporter a moment he will never forget.
Yeah, it was a good hug, good hug.
So a fun night at the football resulted in an experience one Bomber fan will never forget. Welcome back to Network 10's exclusive coverage of the 2004 Brownlow Medal. Let's get back to the vote count and round 3.
thought the umpiring was actually quite disgraceful.
Yes, from villain back to hero again, James Hird was truly unforgettable in round three. The Bombers' thrilling victory over West Coast also achieved with the assistance of Matthew Lloyd, who slotted eight.
No doubt about that shot, but there was about this one at the Gabba. Where do you find an umpire like that, Eddie?
The goal umpire from hell.
Maybe the Easter full moon was getting to the players. A spiteful match between St Kilda and Richmond produced some heavy suspensions. Stephen Baker copping 4 weeks.
And it looked as if they'd be joined by Shane Crawford on the sidelines, but he was cleared.
His rival captain wasn't so lucky. A knee injury ending the season of Matthew Primus, a black spot in the Power's 81-point win.
And it was line ball at the MCG. This out-of-bounds call on Ryan Houlihan thrust Daniel Wells into the spotlight, and didn't he shine in round three?
Round three, Brisbane versus Collingwood. Brisbane, A. McGrath, 1 vote. Brisbane, A. Lynch, 2 votes. Brisbane, L. Power, 3 votes. Kangaroos versus Carlton. Kangaroos, S. Grant, 1 vote. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, 2 votes. Carlton, H. Scotland, 3 votes. Essendon versus West Coast Eagles. West Coast Eagles, C. Judd, 1 vote. West Coast Eagles, P. B. Cousins, 2 votes. Essendon, M. Lloyd, 3 votes. Sydney versus Geelong. Geelong, P. Chapman, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Kelly, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Hawthorn. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, P. Burgoyne, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Melbourne. Melbourne, J. Rivers, 1 vote. Western Bulldogs, S. West, 2 votes. Melbourne, T. Johnston, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Adelaide. Adelaide, K. Massey, 1 vote. Fremantle, S. McManus, 2 votes. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 3 votes. St Kilda versus Richmond. St Kilda, R. Harvey, 1 vote. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 2 votes. St Kilda, N. Revolt, 3 votes.
A missed shot from Nigel Lappin in the dying seconds, and Brisbane's three-year losing streak in the West was maintained.
The Saints took their show on the road and won again. Garrick kicked 6, and his tandem with Nick Revold was a daunting prospect for opposition defences.
A desperate Geelong finally broke the ice. Ben Graham kicked 6, and after 3 defeats, the Cats' season had been kick-started.
Wasn't that great to see? The Bulldogs also scored their first win. Jade Rawlings tasting victory against his former club. And didn't he enjoy it when occasionally he hit the target?
And the Dockers scored a morale-boosting road win, downing Collingwood at Telstra Dome. Without Chris Tarrant up forward, the Magpies were aimless in round four.
Round four, Carlton versus Essendon. Carlton, B. Johnson, 1 vote. Essendon, D. Solomon, 2 votes. Essendon, A. McPhee, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Port Adelaide. Melbourne, D. Neitz, 1 vote. Melbourne, C. Bruce, 2 votes. Melbourne, B. Green, 3 votes. West Coast versus Brisbane. Brisbane, J. Brown, 1 vote. Brisbane, S. Black, 2 votes. West Coast, C. Judd, 3 votes. Adelaide versus St Kilda. St Kilda, N. Revolt, 1 vote. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, 2 votes. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 3 votes. Geelong versus Richmond. Geelong, C. Ling, one vote. Geelong, P. Riccardi, two votes. Geelong, B. Graham, three votes. Kangaroos versus Sydney. Sydney, N. Fosdyke, one vote. Sydney, A. Goods, two votes. Sydney, B. Kirk, three votes. Collingwood versus Fremantle. Fremantle, S. Parker, one vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, two votes. Fremantle, S. McManus, three votes. Hawthorne versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, N. Eagleton, one vote. Western Bulldogs, R. Murphy, two votes. Western Bulldogs, S. West, three votes.
It was already shaping as a long season for Danny Frawley. A fourth straight loss had Tiger fans frothing at the mouth.
Not a pretty sight. The Bombers climbed into the eighth with an Anzac Day victory over Collingwood. James Hurd, a virtuoso performance, adding a third Anzac medal to his plentiful jewellery collection.
Carlton unearthed its long-awaited prize draft pick. Andrew Walker produced a stunning debut, and Carlton heart soared.
Jonathan Brown caught everything that came his way. 17 marks against the Hawks. A gong at the Dome. Gavin Dorr giving Brownlow votes for the 300th time.
And Melbourne continued to surprise. David Meats kicked six as the Demons stormed home to upset the Swans in round five.
Round five, Richmond versus Adelaide. Adelaide, K. McGregor, one vote. Adelaide, A. McLeod, two votes. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, three votes. Carlton versus West Coast. Carlton, A. Walker, one vote. Carlton, H. Scotland, two votes. Carlton, M. Lappin, three votes. St Kilda versus Kangaroos. St Kilda, L. Ball, one vote. St Kilda, H. Black, two votes. St Kilda, L. Hayes, three votes. Brisbane versus Hawthorne. Brisbane, L. Power, one vote. Brisbane, J. Charman, two votes. Brisbane, J. Brown, three votes. Sydney versus Melbourne. Melbourne, J. White, one vote. Melbourne, S. Thompson, two votes. Melbourne, D. Neitz, three votes. Collingwood versus Essendon. Essendon, S. Lucas, one vote. Collingwood, M. McGough, two votes. Essendon, J. Hurd, three votes. Fremantle versus Geelong. Fremantle, L. McFarlane, one vote. Geelong, P. Riccardi, two votes. Fremantle, B. Shammer, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Western Bulldogs. Port Adelaide, B. Ebert, one vote. Port Adelaide, B. Montgomery, two votes. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, three votes.
Five rounds in two. The Brownlow Medal Count for 2004. And boy, aren't some of the hot favourites polling well. What about Chris Judd? He is off to an absolute flyer. He's polled in four matches already. He has nine votes and is the outright leader. Chad Corns, already a career best with seven votes. Neitz on seven, Scotland seven. Treadray, the Brownlow favourite on six. Over the page, Burgoyne five, Nick Dal Santo five, along with Shannon Grant, Paul Hazelby and James Hurd. Let's now cross over to South Australia and speak to the pre-Brownlow medal favourite. Warren Treadray, of course, will be leading the side on Saturday at the MCG. Warren, welcome to the telecast. How's it feel being the pre-Brownlow favourite, and how are you handling it so far?
Handling quite fine. I thought it was quite funny that Chad Corns has already beaten his previous votes. You've got to laugh over here, so there's plenty being said in the background, but yeah.
And the week so far, keeping a lid on everything, everything just going along very nicely?
Yeah, going along quite nicely. We had a number of people out at training today. We had a really light run, and it's a good feeling here in Adelaide. For once, they're barking about us and not the crows, and we're looking forward to the week and hopefully having a successful week.
Warren, thanks for your time. Good luck. We might speak to you later.
Thanks a lot.
Warren Treadray from Port Adelaide. Well, the leader after five rounds of the Brownlow Medal for 2004 is Chris Judd.
Chris Judd on fire early, but Warren Treadray not too far behind, Rob. But let's take a look at a former winner, James Hurd. He was expected to poll three votes in round three against the Eagles, didn't. He's got five, and that was, interestingly, the week that he had the umpiring controversy. So, interesting start for James Hurd, but off to a good start with five.
This is interesting, Chris. We've got Matthew Scarlett, who to this stage has not polled a vote. But you can see there, our Channel 10 computer expects his run to start very soon.
Well, Rob, you were looking great on the red carpet earlier this evening, but you weren't the only one.
There was a lot of things riding on it, I suppose.
People are passionate, footballers are passionate, coaches are passionate, and I think that the passion was sort of going overboard somewhat.
Danny's career was probably riding on a little bit.
Hawthorne down by a point, it could change.
It built up and built up.
A free kick is coming back.
It is such an emotional ride, and especially when that free kick, I thought, oh no, here we go again.
When I got there, I didn't realise that a couple of truckloads from Bungaree came down. And
we sort of both got to have a bit of a cuddle and kiss, which was nice.
Yeah, it was just good to know you had the support there, and that's what football's all about. Sometimes it's bigger than 4 points.
It has been a tough year for the Frawley family. We wish them well, and let's hope Spud stays in the game in some shape or form. Now, to keep you in touch, particularly those watching at home, from now on there will be a little ticker board popping up over my right shoulder. And just to advise you as to who is leading the count for the remainder of the night as we hit round six.
And there was drama everywhere you looked in round six as Richmond held on in that thriller to finally give Danny Frawley a win and a much more pleasant post-match experience.
The fallout for the Hawks continued with Danny Jacobs and Lance Piccioni fined over a drink driving incident.
At the Dome, it was the goal umpire's judgment in question. This Ozzie Jones shot ruled as a behind. The suggested four goal umpires and larger posts certainly weren't needed for Troy Swartz's match winner, which made it six in a row for St Kilda.
The Saints weren't unscathed though. Lenny Hayes out for two.
And in the WA Derby, Frio stayed just ahead of the pursuing Eagles. James Walker was a star, along with Bell and Hazelby.
And at Marnica, the Western Bulldogs somehow beat the Roos, courtesy of the worst-looking goal of Brad Johnson's distinguished career. I'm sure David Smorgon will smile when he looks back on round six.
Round six, Richmond versus Hawthorne. Richmond, W. Campbell, one vote. Hawthorne, P. Everett, two votes. Richmond, G. Tivendale, three votes. Kangaroos versus Western Bulldogs. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, one vote. Western Bulldogs, M. Hahn, two votes. Western Bulldogs, S. West, three votes. Essendon versus Sydney. Sydney, B. Hall, one vote. Essendon, J. Hurd, two votes. Essendon, A. McPhee, three votes. West Coast versus Fremantle. West Coast, D. Kerr, one vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, two votes. Fremantle, P. Bell, three votes. St Kilda versus Brisbane. Brisbane, J. Akamanis, one vote. Brisbane, M. Voss, two votes. St Kilda, L. Hayes, three votes. Geelong versus Adelaide. Geelong, J. Hunt, one vote. Geelong,
P. Chapman, 2 votes. Geelong, C. Ling, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Carlton. Melbourne, J. White, 1 vote. Melbourne, A. Uze, 2 votes. Melbourne, C. Bruce, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Collingwood. Port Adelaide, M. Wilson, 1 vote. Collingwood, M. McGough, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, 3 votes.
The MCG was certainly the place to be in round 7.
Yes, in addition to Ashley Sampy's mark of the year, Carlton unearthed an unlikely hero in Justin Davies, whose 3 last quarter goals, together with 6 from Brendan Favola, ensured a memorable win over Collingwood.
The twang of Nathan Buckley's hamstring had considerably helped their cause, and all this after $42,000 worth of half-time melee.
It was also a costly day for Brodie Holland, whose stray boot was worth 4 weeks, and so was Casey Green's moment of madness.
And Matthew Richardson was back in style, kicking 7 out of 10 against the Swans as the Tigers' season appeared to be heading out of the doldrums.
This put the spotlight firmly on Peter Swobb.
We aren't a bad footy club. It's a great footy club, and it's like everyone else. We're doing all we can, all right?
The strain continued to show as the Hawks went down to the Cats to complete round 7.
Round 7, Western Bulldogs versus Essendon. Western Bulldogs, N. Eagleton, 1 vote. Essendon, M. Lloyd, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, R. Smith, 3 votes. Carlton versus Collingwood. Collingwood, B. Holland, 1 vote. Carlton, M. Lappin, 2 votes. Carlton, N. Stevens, 3 votes. Fremantle versus St Kilda. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, 1 vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 2 votes. St Kilda, L. Ball, 3 votes. Kangaroos versus Brisbane Lions. Brisbane Lions, N. Lappin, 1 vote. Brisbane Lions, J. Lepich, 2 votes. Brisbane Lions, L. Power, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Adelaide. Adelaide, M. Clark, 1 vote. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, 2 votes. Adelaide, T. Stenglein, 3 votes. Sydney versus Richmond. Sydney, P. Williams, 1 vote. Richmond, N. Brown, 2 votes. Richmond, M. Richardson, 3 votes. Melbourne versus West Coast. Melbourne, N. Brown, 1 vote. Melbourne, R. Robertson, 2 votes. Melbourne, A. Uze, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Geelong. Geelong, D. Haynes, 1 vote. Geelong, J. Corey, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Kelly, 3 votes.
So after 7 completed rounds, great to see Matthew Richardson enjoying himself, by the way, enjoying the spoils here at Crown. It is Chad Corns, who's already passed his career best. He's now shot up to 10. He leads by 1 from Paul Hazelby from the Dockers, Chris Judd from the West Coast Eagles, Scott West has got 8 from the Dogs, Adam Uze up to 8 from Melbourne. Over the page, it's Luke Ball on 7, James Hurd on 7, Melbourne's David Neitz on 7, along with Luke Power from the Brisbane Lions, and last year's winner, Mark Ricciuto from the Adelaide Crows. So after round 7 of the Brownlow Count for 2004, your leader from Port Adelaide is Chad Corns.
Rob, getting very interesting, a log jam at the top, Chad Corns now at the front. But let's take a look at Scott West, of course, 5-time best and fairest winner for the Bulldogs, and 8 votes. You can see down the bottom, predicted votes, 6, actual 8, so actually outperforming. He does have a good second half to the season.
And Paul Hazelby's also started off really well. He's second at the moment, and you can see we predict that he will not get too many votes as we get into the second half of the season.
Seven rounds down in the Brownlow Medal. Back shortly with more from Crown Palladium.
Stephen kicked the ball across the face of goal, so I charged across after it.
Oh, it's not a bad one either.
Saw the ball hit the post, and the next thing I remember is seeing the Carlton draft sign directly behind me.
Yeah, copped him, you know, probably 100 kilos, so he didn't last long on his feet.
Darren was the one that made me laugh, I think, more than anything else, because while he was giving me the hit the post all clear, he was saying, "I'm sorry, Fleggy, I can't stop laughing."
After the ball had gone through the points, I went and picked his hat up and just made sure he was still alive.
Quinton had done the right thing, been polite and given me my cap back.
Yeah, well, I sort of was going to put it on forwards, but he was making his signal for the point, so I couldn't sort of cover his eyes up because he's looking at the umpire, so I had to let him do it himself.
No, I don't think I would have been in Darren's votes that day. They take their Brownlow Medal votes very, very seriously.
I think Quinton Lynch deserves a vote for manners there. It can be a tough and dangerous job being a goal umpire. Seven rounds completed in the Brownlow Medal Count for 2004. The leader from Port Adelaide is Chad Corns as we hit round eight.
And Tim, it was bad news week for some big names. Adam Goods hurting his knee at Subiaco.
Jonathan Brown earning more weeks for upending Carlton's Darren Hume. And James Hird sustaining yet another rare injury.
But it was good news week for others. Matthew Richardson with a perfect 10 at the MCG. And Wayne Carey producing the glorious lustre of old with six big ones against the Bombers.
His greatest rival, Glenn Jakovich, closed the book after 277 games for the Eagles, while the Saints equaled the season start made by the legends of 1966.
Well, let's have a look now in a bit more detail, Tim, at some of the players that might get votes in this round. We start with the 2002 champion, Simon Black. He's a fraction off the pace at the moment, 29 disposals, though he should add to his four votes, his total so far.
And there's Ozzie Jones, who had 21 disposals for the Saints against Collingwood. And if the field umpires are as generous as that goalie was in the match against Brisbane, he could get four votes for that.
Well, Chad Corns, of course, is our leader so far. Not a noted vote getter, as we've heard already in the past, but a new position. He gets 22 disposals in this round, but Port Adelaide lose to the Kangaroos. So we'll see how he goes in round eight.
Round eight. Adelaide versus Essendon. Adelaide, W. Carey, one vote. Essendon, J. Johnson, two votes. Essendon, D. Solomon, three votes. Richmond versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, S. West, one vote. Richmond, N. Brown, two votes. Richmond, M. Richardson, three votes. West Coast versus Sydney. West Coast, D. Kerr, one vote. West Coast, C. Fletcher, two votes. West Coast, C. Judd, three votes. Brisbane versus Carlton. Brisbane, L. Power, one vote. Brisbane, N. Lappin, two votes. Brisbane, S. Black, three votes. St Kilda versus Collingwood. St Kilda, S. Milne, one vote. Collingwood, B. Johnson, two votes. St Kilda, J. Kaczynski, three votes. Hawthorne versus Fremantle. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, one vote. Hawthorne, T. Crode, two votes. Hawthorne, C. Bateman, three votes. Geelong versus Melbourne. Melbourne, S. Thompson, one vote. Geelong, D. Milburn, two votes. Geelong, M. Scarlett, three votes. Kangaroos versus Port Adelaide. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, one vote. Kangaroos, L. Colbert, 2 votes. Kangaroos, B. Harvey, 3 votes.
Round 9 opened with a drought-breaking win for Collingwood. Chris Tarrant's 5 goals, the key. At the other end of the ladder, the Saints were ruthless in their 101-point destruction of West Coast. Brent Guerra kicked 7. But the Gold King star of the round was Paul Medhurst with 9 as the Dockers pummeled Brisbane. Geelong's 2 fine defenders, Tom Harley and Matthew Scarlett, reached 100 games together on a big night for the Cats at the Dome. And in Sydney, the Swans saw red as the Hawks and umpires both wore yellow. The Swans home by a point. He's inside 50. Lee Colbert saw only stars, yet again risking life and limb as against Melbourne. He stayed on track, though, in round 9. And once again, we look for some of the vote getters, perhaps, for this round. James Kelly, we saw the Cats' big victory. Doing well. We know he breaks his leg later in the season. So far, he's on 6 votes. He gets 21 disposals in this round and kicks a couple of goals.
Paul Hazelby, up in the top 4, had 31 disposals as Frio beat the Western Bulldogs. Polled 13 votes last year, already has 9 this year.
And Chad Corns, we've seen he's slipped down to 2nd place on 10 votes. He has a lull after this for perhaps a couple of weeks, but this is a big one, 31 disposals against the Tigers. Let's see how he goes in round 9.
Round 9, Collingwood versus Adelaide. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, 1 vote. Collingwood, C. Tarrant, 2 votes. Collingwood, P. Lecuria, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Brisbane. Brisbane, J. Akamanis, 1 vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 2 votes. Fremantle, P. Medhurst, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, 1 vote. Melbourne, N. Brown, 2 votes. Melbourne, J. White, 3 votes. Geelong versus Essendon. Geelong, P. Chapman, 1 vote. Geelong, K. Kingsley, 2 votes. Geelong, P. Riccardi, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Richmond. Port Adelaide, M. Wilson, 1 vote. Richmond, J. Bowden, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, 3 votes. Sydney versus Hawthorne. Hawthorne, S. Mitchell, 1 vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, 2 votes. Hawthorne, R. Vandenberg, 3 votes. Carlton versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, J. McMahon, 1 vote. Carlton, D. Teague, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs, R. Murphy, 3 votes. St Kilda versus West Coast. St Kilda, B. Guerra, 1 vote. St Kilda, A. Jones, 2 votes. St Kilda, N. Revolt, 3 votes.
Boy, are the leaders polling some votes. Chad Corns, as I said, is well past his career best now as we check the leaderboard. After round 9, he's up to 13 votes. He's got 4 best on grounds already. Extraordinary effort. Chris Judd, just 1 behind on 12. Paul Hazelby's got 11 in 3rd spot. Scott West in 4th spot with 9. Luke Power has got 8. Over the page, Mark Ricciuto well in contention with 8. Matthew Richardson from the Tigers has 8, as does Adam Uze from Melbourne. And on 7, St Kilda youngster Luke Ball. And Simon Black is in the top 10 with 7 votes. And it's with pleasure now we go straight up to Brisbane and speak with the 2002 Brownlow medalist, Simon Black. Welcome, Simon.
Thanks, Dave.
Well, a couple of years ago, mate, you won it, and of course you were part of grand final week. Did it have, as you look back now, did it have any impact at all?
Oh, look, it's an interesting week as far as distractions. There's a lot of those that go on, but, you know, when you're inside a footy club that's, you know, a lot of 20, 25 guys in the group for that week are involved, it's, it makes it a lot easier. You focus on the job and they get you through it okay.
How have you rated this year compared to your Brownlow year in 2002?
Look, yeah, probably haven't been quite as consistent as that year, but yeah, been a great year for the group to get there again on the weekend and yeah, thoroughly enjoyed it.
And quickly, how's Jonathan Brown's knee?
Look, you know, as far as I know at the moment, he would have a bit of physio and that sort of thing today, but I'd be very surprised if he wasn't out there on Saturday afternoon.
Beautifully answered, Simon. Well done and good luck tonight. Simon Black from the Brisbane Lions. And after 9 completed rounds, the leader in the Brownlow medal is Chad Corns.
Is Chad Corns spoiling the party for Warren Treadray? Well, the West Australian's also doing pretty well. Chris Judd right up there in second position. Predicted votes to this stage, Rob, just 8, but he's got 12. So you can see coming home with a rush as well. So a big chance tonight, Chris Judd.
Well, Chris Judd going exceptionally well, but so too is Chad Corns. We predicted he'd have 8 votes to this stage. Well, he's already up to 13. That move to centre half back has been wonderful for him.
Our leader is Chad Corns in the Brownlow medal, a night of colour and fashion.
You know that Collingwood was beaten that day and that would be the end of their finals.
It's on!
Got sort of into the 20-minute mark of the end of the game and we thought, we're in front. I think we could have held it from here and Bill's going, come on, Warren, come on. We're going to use this banner now. We're going to use it. I said, no, just wait for the final siren.
A fantastic performance from Melbourne.
That was pretty cheeky from Melbourne supporters because they're usually very, very sterile.
And the crowd was rapt. The crowd was rapt to see it. Not only that, they were rapt to see the next day of their picture in the paper.
It was actually quite funny because everything that we do is in the spirit of things and having fun, and it was just good to see the Melbourne people get into it.
What happened to the banner was we all decided to destroy it like we destroyed Collingwood that day.
Good girl, good girl.
And it's great to see Joffa developing a sense of humour. Mind you, it wasn't only Collingwood supporters who needed to keep their sense of humour in 2004. We're nearing the halfway mark of the Brownlow medal count. Let's go to round 10.
Officially diagnosed with clinical depression.
And a dose of reality for the football world in round 10. A brave Nathan Thompson soldiering on, this time against the rampant Mark Rusciuto, who was celebrating game number 250.
It only got worse for the Hawks. Shane Crawford's broken arm meant his season was over. Jason Saddington's knee ended his.
Bulldog captain Chris Grant also went down, but how, we still don't know.
And meanwhile, Brendan Favola got a taste of life at the other end. 5 Fraser Gehry first quarter goals ended the experiment. Fraser ended with 9.
Ben Graham kicked 5, but missed the one that mattered most as Port Adelaide broke loose in the final moments to hang on to a thrilling victory against the Cats at Amy Stadium.
Well, the 3 leading players are from clubs that have not produced a Brownlow medalist. Hutto, have you got a standout in round 10?
Well, Mark Rusciuto, we know he is one of the winners from last year. He's going well. He's got a good spell coming up. He's on 8 votes so far in 5th place, 35 touches in this game, number 250 and 3 goals.
Lenny Hayes, promoted contentiously to the captaincy at St Kilda, has had a terrific year. 37 disposals against Carlton should tally votes for him.
And Nigel Lappin has a great game, 28 disposals. He's on 3 votes so far tonight, so he has a very strong second half of the season, but he is a little behind on what we thought so far. We'll see if he polls in round 10.
Round 10, Essendon versus Fremantle. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, 1 vote. Essendon, A. McPhee, 2 votes. Essendon, A. Welsh, 3 votes. Hawthorn versus Adelaide. Adelaide, G. Johncock, 1 vote. Adelaide, T. Edwards, 2 votes. Adelaide, M. Rusciuto, 3 votes. West Coast Eagles versus Richmond. West Coast, P. Matera, 1 vote. Richmond, K. Johnson, 2 votes. West Coast, C. Judd, 3 votes. Kangaroos versus Collingwood. Kangaroos, A. Simpson,
one vote. Collingwood, P. Lecuria, two votes. Collingwood, B. Johnson, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus Sydney. Sydney, J. Bolton, one vote. Sydney, T. Kennelly, two votes. Sydney, P. Williams, three votes. Melbourne versus Brisbane. Brisbane, N. Lappin, one vote. Brisbane, M. Voss, two votes. Brisbane, C. Johnson, three votes. Carlton versus St Kilda. St Kilda, F. Gehrig, one vote. St Kilda, L. Hayes, two votes. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Geelong. Geelong, T. Harley, one vote. Port Adelaide, M. Wilson, two votes. Port Adelaide, J. Schofield, three votes.
There was plenty to get tongues wagging through round 11. And reckless courage seemed to be contagious with Jonathan Brown, James Bartel, and finally Nick Riewoldt putting themselves in serious danger.
What a grab that was. The other SCG highlights, though, were all from the Swans as Barry Hall with five goals, Matthew Nix with four, finally ended St Kilda's unbeaten run.
More frustration for Collingwood. Tarrant, 2 weeks for this.
But that was nothing compared to the Hawks, who drew a line in the sand, some blood, but not that elusive victory. What did Doom say, I wonder?
I'd love to know. The hero of the round, though, was Carlton's Brendan Favola, who sunk his seventh goal of the day and the Adelaide Crows in spectacular fashion.
Coming up to the halfway stage of the count, it's a very high-scoring count. Let's again look at some who might poll in this round. We'll start with Jeff White from Melbourne, one of the favourites. Just the five votes so far. He's never been a huge poller of votes in the past, but 19 disposals, 30 hit-outs. Maybe you'll get some votes in this round.
What about Chris Judd? 27 disposals in this round and five tackles. He had 12 career votes before tonight. He's on 15 after 10 rounds.
He's on fire. Luke Power also going well from the Lions. Eight votes so far, 26 disposals and three goals against Port. We'll find out now whether he gets votes in round 11.
Round 11. Collingwood versus West Coast. West Coast, C. Judd, one vote. Collingwood, P. Lecuria, two votes. West Coast, A. Embley, three votes. Adelaide versus Carlton. Carlton, S. Camporeale, one vote. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, two votes. Carlton, B. Favola, three votes. Hawthorn versus Essendon. Essendon, M. Lloyd, one vote. Essendon, D. Rioli, two votes. Essendon, S. Lucas, three votes. Brisbane versus Port Adelaide. Brisbane, J. Brown, one vote. Brisbane, N. Lappin, two votes. Brisbane, L. Power, three votes. Kangaroos versus Richmond. Kangaroos, T. Makepeace, one vote. Kangaroos, S. Rocker, two votes. Kangaroos, D. Harris, three votes. Sydney versus St Kilda. St Kilda, N. Del Santo, one vote. Sydney, B. Hall, two votes. Sydney, L. Barry, three votes. Bulldogs versus Geelong. Geelong, G. Ablett, one vote. Geelong, J. Bartel, two votes. Geelong, C. Mooney, three votes. Fremantle versus Melbourne. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, one vote. Melbourne, B. Green, two votes. Melbourne, J. White, three votes.
So we're at the halfway mark of the Brownlow Medal Count. Now, if you're following a particular player, they're not polling too well, don't be too upset, because at the halfway mark last year, the three winners, Adam Goods had 11 votes, Nathan Buckley had 8, and Mark Rusciutto had just 5. So plenty of hope if your particular player is not polling too well at this stage. But how's this at the halfway mark? Chris Judd, the leader, with 16 votes, 3 clear of Chad Cordens from Port Adelaide. Also on 13 is Mark Rusciutto, one of last year's winners. Paul Hazelby has 11, as does Luke Power, a member of the Fab 5 from the Brisbane Lions. Nick Dal Santo with 10, Scott West on 9, Lenny Hayes has 8, as does Adam McPhee from the Bombers. And Richmond's Matthew Richardson also has 8. So our leader at the halfway mark of the Brownlow Medal Count from the West Coast Eagles is that man, Chris Judd.
And Rob, Chris Judd absolutely on fire. He's absolutely flying at the moment. But last year's winner, Mark Rusciutto, is coming with a rush. He's polled very well in the first half. We predicted 12. He scored 13, but does have a quiet second half to the season in terms of what our computer says.
And Luke Power, gee, isn't he polling well? We predicted he'd only have 6 votes to this stage. He's already got 11. And you can see there, we predict he'll get plenty more in the second part of the season.
We're at the halfway mark of the 2004 Brownlow Medal. Back shortly from Crown Palladium.
We're at the halfway mark of the count. Let's recap the top 5, and they are all non-Victorian, as it was back in 2001 at the halfway mark. Chris Judd from the West Coast Eagles has 16 votes, followed by Chad Cordens from Port Adelaide with 13. Also on 13, Mark Rusciutto from the Crows, and on 11 votes, Paul Hazelby from the Fremantle Dockers and Luke Power from the Brisbane Lions. Let's get into round 12.
Again. Round 12 saw the Brisbane machine crank up again. Michael Voss had 30 touches, and with help from Akamanis and Black, the frustrated Bombers found it all rather difficult to stomach.
The earth tremors at the MCG were all caused by the Bulldogs, who were finally barking. The Saints down for the second week in a row, with Rowan Smith, the unlikely hero, in front of goal with 4. It had been a long time coming.
So too had a Fremantle win at the MCG, but with Schammer and Hazelby firing, Freo got home by 10.
And on Monday, Melbourne confirmed its status as a genuine contender. David Neitz's 3rd goal brought to an end a run of 3 Collingwood wins. Well, we've got a centre-half back in contention, but it's not a great award for fullbacks. No fullback has won since Verdon Howell in 1959. How are they faring, Hutto?
Well, it doesn't look like Matthew Scarlett's going to add to that tally, Tim. The fullback jinx continuing, as you mentioned, 3 votes only so far. Does very well in this round, though, against the Kangaroos and the cold down there at Skilled Stadium. 11 marks and 18 disposals.
Scott West, of course, has won 5 club best and fairest. I wonder if he can add to that tonight. 40 disposals in the forthcoming round.
Warren Treadray, he's on 6. Of course, he was the favourite coming in. He expect him to finish strongly, but he'll need to from here. He has 19 disposals, 10 marks and 4 goals in this round. He'll need votes in round 12.
Round 12. Carlton versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn, P. Everett, 1 vote. Carlton, H. Scotland, 2 votes. Carlton, B. Favola, 3 votes. Essendon versus Brisbane. Brisbane, D. Bradshaw, 1 vote. Brisbane, S. Black, 2 votes. Brisbane, M. Voss, 3 votes. Geelong versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, 1 vote. Geelong, M. Scarlett, 2 votes. Geelong, D. Wojcinski, 3 votes. Richmond versus Fremantle. Richmond, M. Richardson, 1 vote. Fremantle, P. Hazelby, 2 votes. Fremantle, B. Schammer, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Collingwood. Collingwood, J. Cloak, 1 vote. Melbourne, A. Uze, 2 votes. Collingwood, J. Fraser, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Sydney. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, one vote. Port Adelaide, P. Burgoyne, two votes. Port Adelaide, M. Wilson, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus St Kilda. Western Bulldogs, R. Smith, one vote. Western Bulldogs, N. Eagleton, two votes. Western Bulldogs, S. West, three votes. West Coast Eagles versus Adelaide. West Coast, A. Embley, one vote. West Coast, D. Kerr, two votes. West Coast, D. Cox, three votes.
The split round brought change in Adelaide. Nigel Smart, the last of the originals, calling it quits after 278 games.
8-goal for Vola. When he was good, he was brilliant. But when he was bad, he was in trouble. 2 weeks' worth, in fact.
The news continued to be good for Melbourne, beating Essendon for the first time in 5 years.
While on a chilly day, the young Cats beat Brisbane at Skilled Stadium, rising to their greatest heights yet.
And the man who had known the highest highs and the lowest lows called it quits.
The exodus from Adelaide didn't stop there. Neil Craig was now the coach. And there would also be change at Richmond, but not till season's end.
And the exact date of that end remained up in the air for the Swans, who downed Collingwood. The Magpies could just about book their September holidays.
Well, we talked about the defenders, Tim. What about the full forwards? We know some of them are going okay, but Brendan Favola, not quite as good as we thought. Three on the trot, though, coming up for the Blues with this win in round 13 against Richmond, as we saw there. Brendan Favola, 8 goals, 5, 10 marks and 16 touches.
Well, I keep talking up Scott West, second consecutive round, 33 touches against Adelaide, 11 marks, and I reckon he might add to his tally of 12.
Well, he may well do, as might Michael Voss, who's got 10 tonight. He's such a great polar over the years, 19 last year, and of course he was the 96 co-winner. 23 disposals, although the Lions did lose against Geelong in round 13.
Round 13. Sydney versus Collingwood. Collingwood, P. Lecuria, one vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, two votes. Sydney, J. Bolton, three votes. Essendon versus Melbourne. Melbourne, A. Uze, one vote. Melbourne, N. Brown, two votes. Melbourne, J. White, three votes. Richmond versus Carlton. Carlton, M. Lappin, one vote. Richmond, J. Bowden, two votes. Carlton, B. Favola, three votes. St Kilda versus Hawthorn. St Kilda, S. Milne, one vote. St Kilda, L. Hayes, two votes. St Kilda, S. Powell, three votes. Geelong versus Brisbane. Geelong, D. Wojcinski, one vote. Brisbane, N. Lappin, two votes. Geelong, B. Graham, three votes. Fremantle versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, T. Thurston's, one vote. Port Adelaide, R. James, two votes. Fremantle, P. Bell, three votes. Kangaroos versus West Coast. Kangaroos, D. Harris, one vote. Kangaroos, A. Simpson, two votes. Kangaroos, A. Stevens, three votes. Adelaide versus Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, S. West, one vote. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, two votes. Adelaide, S. Welsh, three votes.
Well, it is a hot count tonight, and Chris Judd still with his nose in front. as we check the top 10 leaderboard. He has 16 votes, one ahead of one of last year's winners, Mark Ricciuto on 15, Chad Corn stuck on 13, Paul Hazelby on 13, and Scott West polling particularly well also on 13. Luke Powers on 11, Jeff White from Melbourne is 11, as is his Melbourne teammate Adam Uze. Nick Dal Santo from the Saints has 10, as does the skipper from St Kilda, Lenny Hayes, also with 10. Let's now speak to a man who is leading the count at the moment. He, in his short career, has already proven that he can handle the pressure. Chris Judd, how are you handling the pressure tonight?
Very well, yeah.
You're Mike, mate, that's okay.
Thank you.
You came here tonight, what were your expectations?
Oh, it was just good to catch up with, you know, all the boys have come down from Perth and haven't seen them for a couple of weeks, so good to catch up with them, have a couple of drinks and enjoy the night.
Are you aware of the West Coast Eagles' history in the Brownlow? Craig Turley second, Matera second, winners.
I'm aware of it now, but I haven't been studying it, truth be honest.
All right, mate, well, you never know, you might be the first, so good luck for the rest of the count. Chris Judd, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, Steve.
Good on you, mate. And after 13 completed rounds, here's our leader, Chris Judd.
Yes, the Western Australian champ leading by a vote, but one of the challengers is Chad Corns, who had a wonderful season with Port Adelaide, and he's polled better than we expected, Rob. He's polled 13, we predicted only 8, and he does come home very hard, so Chad Corns, a big chance for the medal.
And another young player, Nick Dal Santo, the young saint, he's full of class. We didn't think he'd vote as well as he had. We thought he might have had 6 votes to this stage. He's got 10, and you can see there we predict a 3-voter coming up in a few rounds' time.
Well, Rob, it's hot in the Palladium, but it was even hotter earlier this evening on the red carpet.
City block in front of all the trams, stopping the trams, and it was just a wonderful feeling. I'm up here in where I live at Arcadia, and I work on my old hall here, and been renovating this for a few years. My neighbour across the road and a few friends had the logo bought up from the Brisbane Lions in Melbourne, and it's now the Lions Den. I put it on the chain and wear it around my neck when I go out anywhere, and it's come in very handy because you might bump into a father that's there with his young son or daughter and they want to get a photo taken, and I put the Brownlow around the boy or the girl's neck or the dad's neck, and you know, they appreciate that, and I get a thrill out of that. To go down in history as one of the Brownlow medal winners is a mighty feeling.
There he is, the winner of the 1969 Brownlow Medal, Kevin Murray. 333 games, 9 best and fairests, and the second oldest man ever to win the Brownlow behind Barry Round. Incidentally, the third oldest was one of the winners from last year, Nathan Buckley. Let's recap the top 5 after 13 completed rounds for the Brownlow Medal count for 2004. And it's Chris Judd from the West Coast Eagles, one in front of Mark Ricciuto from the Adelaide Crows. Port Adelaide's Chad Corns shares third spot with Paul Hazelby from Fremantle and Scott West from the Western Bulldogs. Time now for round 14.
John Howard in attendance.
Anyone would have thought there was an election on the horizon, but it was Barry Hall who put himself in line for votes with 6 goals in the Swans' win in round 14. Meantime, another master politician had just signed a new 3-year term, but that didn't help the Bombers, who let a 21-point lead slip as Sav Rocker booted 5 and got the ruse home. No such joy for the Hawks, who were sinking deeper into the mire. Nathan Buckley enjoying a rare 65-point Collingwood win.
Geelong watched on helplessly as James Kelly broke his leg, and as our leader Chris Judd helped himself to 28 possessions at Subi.
Contender Chad Corns was another in magnificent form. 34 touches helped bury the stumbling Saints, who had 3 players go into the umpire's book.
And 8 Scott Welsh goals took the Crows to a whopping 72-point win over Melbourne, and Neil Craig must have thought the job was easy.
And it sounds as though our leader is a chance for more votes, Hutto.
Yes, certainly. He certainly led the way for the West Coast Eagles in their win against the Cats. 28 touches and 2 goals.
And Mark Ricciuto in second position, just a vote away, had 26 possessions against Melbourne. Could he go back to back?
Well, he might. Chad Corns, as we mentioned, another one who is contending, 13 votes at the moment. We saw on the highlights there, 34 touches. He was dominant across half-back. Will it be enough to get him the 3 votes?
Round 14.
Essendon versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos, B. Rawlings, one vote. Kangaroos, S. Grant, two votes. Essendon, J. Murphy, three votes. Carlton versus Sydney. Sydney, B. Hall, one vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, two votes. Carlton, S. Camporeale, three votes. Collingwood versus Hawthorne. Collingwood, B. Holland, one vote. Collingwood, A. Didak, two votes. Collingwood, J. Fraser, three votes. Brisbane versus Richmond. Richmond, N. Brown, one vote. Richmond, J. Schultz, two votes. Brisbane, N. Lappin, three votes. Adelaide versus Melbourne. Adelaide, T. Edwards, one vote. Adelaide, S. Welsh, two votes. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, three votes. St Kilda versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, S. Burgoyne, one vote. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, two votes. Port Adelaide, D. Brogan, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus Fremantle. Fremantle, L. McFarlane, one vote. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, two votes. Western Bulldogs, S. West, three votes. West Coast versus Geelong. Geelong, J. Bartell, one vote. West Coast, D. Kerr, two votes. West Coast, C. Judd, three votes.
Round 15 began with a celebration for James Hurd's 200th.
It didn't last long. A broken rib would mean another three-week spell.
But of course, Matthew Lloyd was still standing, and he kicked nine as Richmond were destroyed by 78 points.
Tiger fans must have felt like chucking it in.
Some big names went into the book. Matthew Scarlett was cleared, but Jonathan Brown copped four.
And back at the MCG, it was Nick Riewoldt versus Melbourne. Riewoldt kicked nine, but Jeff White was becoming a contender as he led the Demons to a 57-point win.
The highlight of the round, though, Daniel Wells as match winner in Perth. It must have been good to prompt this sort of reaction from Dean Laidley. Well, we've been saying that Warren Treadray's about to make his move, Tim, all night. He's on seven votes. It's amazing. He was awesome, though, against Carlton. He had 19 touches, 15 marks. Surely he'll get some votes this round.
Barry Hall hasn't quite got among the votes the way he got among the goals during the year. Just has seven, but kicked four against Adelaide in round 15 in tough conditions.
And Scotty West, he's on 16. He's surprised a little. He's had a great year, of course. 25 disposals against Brisbane, seven clearances. Let's see how he goes in round 15.
Round 15. Melbourne versus St Kilda. Melbourne, J. White, one vote. St Kilda, N. Riewoldt, two votes. Melbourne, C. Bruce, three votes. Brisbane versus Western Bulldogs. Brisbane, J. Brown, one vote. Brisbane, M. Pike, two votes. Brisbane, J. Akamanis, three votes. Sydney versus Adelaide. Adelaide, M. Doughty, one vote. Sydney, T. Kennelly, two votes. Sydney, B. Kirk, three votes. Fremantle versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos, S. Rocker, one vote. Fremantle, B. Shammer, two votes. Kangaroos, D. King, three votes. Collingwood versus Geelong. Collingwood. N. Buckley, one vote. Geelong. C. Ling, two votes. Geelong. J. Bartel, three votes. Richmond versus Essendon. Essendon. M. Lloyd, one vote. Essendon. T. Richards, two votes. Essendon. A. McPhee, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Carlton. Port Adelaide. W. Treadray, one vote. Port Adelaide. J. Schofield, two votes. Port Adelaide. J. Carr, three votes. Hawthorne versus West Coast Eagles. West Coast Eagles. D. Wirrupanda, one vote. West Coast Eagles. C. Judd, two votes. Hawthorne. N. Thompson, three votes.
Well, Chris Judd has been just so consistent in this Brownlow Medal Count for 2004. What a night he is having. Still a long way to go, though, but he leads by three votes on 21 already. Mark Rusciutto from the Adelaide Crows has 18. Scott West up to 16. Chad Corns has 15. Brett Kirk polling particularly well from the Sydney Swans on 14. Over the page in sixth spot is Paul Hazelby with 13. Jeff White from Melbourne has 12. And Nigel Lappin, Adam McPhee and Luke Power from the Brisbane Lions all have 11. So after round 15, the leader in the Brownlow Medal for 2004 with 21 votes is this man, Chris Judd.
What a performance from Chris Judd, Rob, three clear. There's still plenty of chances though. What about Adelaide captain Mark Rusciutto? Three behind, but the problem with Mark Rusciutto, does he poll enough votes in the last seven or eight games? That's going to be the big question.
And Scott West, gee, is he polling well? He's had a brilliant season, the midfielder from the Western Bulldogs. We thought he'd vote well, thought he'd have 14 votes to this stage. Well, he's got 16, so our computer, it's doing a fine job.
Just seven rounds to go in the 2004 Brownlow Medal. The excitement is really building.
Welcome back to Network 10's exclusive coverage of the 2004 Brownlow Medal here at Crown. Chris Judd, only 21 years of age from the West Coast Eagles, but already tonight he has compiled 21 votes in this Brownlow Medal count as we recap the top five as it stands at the moment after round 15. As I said, Judd with 21, Mark Rusciutto, one of last year's winners. Could it be back-to-back for the Roo? He's got 18 votes. Scott West from the Western Bulldogs has 16 votes. Chad Corns, who played some good football near the end of the season, up to 15. And Brett Kirk also polling very well from the Sydney Swans with 14. Time now for the votes for round 16.
And the captaincy was clearly not a burden for our leader as the Eagles cleaned up the Bombers. Kevin Sheedy hardly needed a reminder of the score, but he got it.
Maybe Sheed's had an excuse for a lack of bite after the unusual injury to Dustin Fletcher.
The Saints got their hunger back with Ozzie Jones engineering a comfortable win over Richmond.
Alistair Lynch celebrated 300 with the Elements and the Pies providing initial opposition before the Lions found that sublime extra gear, and soon the scoreline was all too familiar for the Pies.
And Aaron Davies' speed proved too much even for his own body, while the Corns boys had 52 possessions between them as Port got a much needed win at the MCG at the expense of the listless Hawks. Well, it's been said in the modern day that the Brownlow is a midfielder's award. They're dominating again.
They are. As we've seen, Chris Judd is certainly flying. 21 votes. 22 won it last year. He was great against the Bombers, as we've seen. 22 touches, a classy performance all night.
And from the other Western Australian team, Paul Hazelby is on 13. He had 26 disposals in round 16 against the Dons.
And Mark Rusciutto's got some good form to come, 18 votes. They lose to Frio in this game, but he gets 34 touches, so he may well poll in round 16.
Round 16, Carlton versus Kangaroos. Carlton, M. Lappin, one vote. Carlton, D. Teague, two votes. Kangaroos, M. Stevens, three votes. Collingwood versus Brisbane. Brisbane, C. McRae, one vote. Brisbane, S. Black, two votes. Brisbane, L. Power, three votes. Geelong versus Sydney. Sydney, B. Kirk, one vote. Sydney, J. Bolton, two votes. Geelong, J. Corey, three votes. Richmond versus St Kilda. Richmond, M. Richardson, one vote. St Kilda, N. Revolt, two votes. St Kilda, A. Jones, three votes. Melbourne versus Western Bulldogs. Melbourne, P. Reid, one vote. Melbourne, D. Neitz, two votes. Melbourne, J. White, three votes. Port Adelaide versus Hawthorn. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, one vote. Port Adelaide, A. Kingsley, two votes. Port Adelaide, K. Corns, three votes. Adelaide versus Fremantle. Fremantle, S. Thornton, one vote. Fremantle, B. Shammer, two votes. Adelaide, M. Ricciuto, three votes. West Coast Eagles versus Essendon. West Coast, D. Wirrupanda, one vote. West Coast, C. Morrison, two votes. West Coast, C. Fletcher, three votes.
But a tough 12 months.
Peter Swobb's days were numbered to one, as it turned out. An 80-point thrashing changed his mind about staying on, and suddenly Donald McDonald was in charge at Glenferrie.
Nick Revolt was in charge at the Telstra Dome. 15 between him and Fraser Gehrig took care of the Bombers. Barry Hall, dragged against Fremantle, vented his spleen.
Did he?
Yeah, no, he was happy to come off there.
The main drama for Brisbane was keeping count in their 23-goal drubbing of Adelaide. Black brilliant, and Acker completed the whitewash with four in the final term.
The only downside was the long-term knee injury to Jamie Charman.
Long-term wasn't something Peter Rowe could think about after another disappointing display against Collingwood. He did, of course, have the full support of the board. All right, let's get into some more players who might poll in round 17. And Simon Black, he's going okay. He's on 11 votes. Needs to get a move on 37 touches, as we saw in that match at the Gabba. Four tackles and a couple of goals.
Brett Kirk, lying equal fifth. Classic late maturer, 27 years of age, and another 29 disposals in a loss to Fremantle.
And Chad Corns, we've been following his progress all night, 16 votes, he plays West Coast in this round, 27 disposals, 10 marks. I wonder if he'll poll in round 17.
Round 17, Richmond versus Melbourne. Melbourne, C. Bruce, one vote. Melbourne, B. Miller, two votes. Melbourne, N. Brown, three votes. Geelong versus Carlton. Geelong, J. Corey, one vote. Geelong, G. Ablett, two votes. Geelong, P. Chapman, three votes. Fremantle versus Sydney. Fremantle, J. Farmer, one vote. Sydney, B. Kirk, two votes. Fremantle, D. Headland, three votes. Kangaroos versus Hawthorn. Kangaroos. D. Petrie, one vote. Kangaroos. D. Motlop, two votes. Kangaroos. D. Wells, three votes. Brisbane versus Adelaide. Brisbane. L. Power, one vote. Brisbane. S. Black, two votes. Brisbane. J. Akamanis, three votes. St. Kilda versus Essendon. St. Kilda. A. Jones, one vote. St. Kilda. N. Revolt, two votes. St. Kilda. F. Gehrig, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus Collingwood. Western Bulldogs. S. West, one vote. Collingwood. N. Buckley, two votes. Collingwood. B. Johnson, three votes. Port Adelaide versus West Coast Eagles. Port Adelaide. W. Treadray, one vote. West Coast. D. Kerr, two votes. Port Adelaide. C. Corns, three votes.
Well, just a little bit of emotion there showed now by Chad Corns. He is rising to the top as we have a look at the leaderboard after round 17. And now we have dual leaders, Chris Judd from the West Coast Eagles and Mark Ricciuto from the Adelaide Crows, both on 21. Chad Corns shoots up to third spot with 19 votes. Brett Kirk, he had three career votes before tonight. He's 17, along with the Western Bulldogs, Scott West. Over the page, Luke Power has 15, along with Jeff White from Melbourne, Simon Black from the Lions, 13. And he shares that spot with Paul Hazelby from Fremantle and Nick Revolt from St Kilda. Let's go back to the floor here and speak with a man who may be shooting for back-to-back Brownlows, Mark Ricciuto. Welcome.
Thanks, Steve.
Well, last year was surprise enough. What about back-to-back? How does that feel?
Yeah, I wasn't expecting it, but getting a bit nervous at the moment.
Well, you must be, you're a big experienced campaigner now, wouldn't you?
Not really, mate. Come here expecting just to have a good night, but got a few votes I didn't expect, so we'll see what happens.
And just quickly, how did you rate? All the experts said that this year was even better than last year. How did you rate it?
It wasn't a too bad a year, but we didn't win too many games, so from team's point of view, it wasn't a great year, but I got a few kicks in the first half, so it was good.
Stay off the beer, mate. You might be up here soon.
Oh, we'll see what happens.
Good on you, Mark. Mark Ricciuto from the Adelaide Crows. So, our leaders after 17 rounds of football, Chris Judd and Mark Ricciuto.
Is it a race in two? Let's look at what lay ahead for our equal leader, Chris Judd. He polls. We expect him to poll in rounds 21 and 22. As you can see, he's actual 21. We only expected him to get 17. A big chance, Chris Judd.
He's going very well. And Simon Black, he's just starting to sneak up. And you can see there that we predicted he'd have 18 votes at this stage. He's only got the 13. He's sitting in eighth position. But we think there are more votes to come.
17 rounds completed. Just five to go. Let's take in some more action from the red carpet earlier this evening.
Welcome back to Crown here in Melbourne for the 2004 Brownlow Medal Count on your Premiership Network Channel 10. Let's recap the leaderboard, the top five, and it is very, very tight at the top. It's a two-way tie, 21 votes apiece at the moment between West Coast Eagles' Chris Judd and Adelaide Crows' Mark Ricciuto. In third spot, outright third from Port Adelaide, is Chad Corns. Brett Kirk from the Sydney Swans has 17, as does Scott West from the Western Bulldogs. Five rounds to go. Time now for round 18.
Oh, the heritage round, and yet again it was the men in white setting the trend.
Collingwood's David King was in the right place as the Magpies had a last-gasp win over Richmond.
Matty Lloyd imposed himself on Port. His seven goals kept the Dons' September dreaming.
And the Swans again found Brisbane's Achilles heel.
But the wheels continued to wobble for the Bulldogs. After being pounded by the Eagles, the fallout saw Peter Rhodes sacked, although he did decide to stay on until season's end.
In one of the matches of the season, the league's two best young lists met at Geelong. Revolt and Scarlett provided the moments. The Cats got the points.
And the Guernseys may have been different, but the result was the same. Another Melbourne win, another Hawthorn loss. It left the D's on top of the ladder. And in round 18, none of our top three had 20 disposals. Maybe a chance for those behind them to come at them, Hutto.
Let's have a look at Scotty West. 17 votes so far, four off the pace. He gets 31 touches against the Eagles, as we saw the Bulldogs do go down.
Jeff White was on 15 votes going into the round. As Melbourne beat Hawthorn, he had 21 hit-outs, seven marks.
And Paul Hazelby, who had a fine first half to the season, 13 votes he is so far. Freo do beat Carlton here, 22 disposals, so maybe he can add to that total in round 18.
Round 18, Collingwood versus Richmond. Richmond, K. Johnson, one vote. Collingwood, B. Johnson, two votes. Richmond, J. Bowden, three votes. Melbourne versus Hawthorn. Melbourne, D. Neitz, one vote. Melbourne, T. Johnston, two votes. Melbourne, A. Uze, three votes. Carlton versus Fremantle. Carlton, M. Lappin, one vote. Fremantle, D. Headland, two votes. Fremantle, M. Pavlich, three votes. Geelong versus St Kilda. Geelong, S. King, one vote. Geelong, J. Bartell, two votes. St Kilda, H. Black, three votes. Sydney versus Brisbane. Sydney, B. Hall, one vote. Brisbane, N. Lappin, two votes. Sydney, J. Bolton, three votes. Adelaide versus Kangaroos. Adelaide, N. Bassett, one vote. Kangaroos, D. Harris, two votes. Adelaide, H. Skipworth, three votes. Essendon versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, A. Kingsley, one vote. Essendon, M. Lloyd, two votes. Essendon, J. Johnson, three votes. West Coast versus Western Bulldogs. West Coast, D. Kerr, one vote. West Coast, M. Braun, two votes. West Coast, D. Atkins, three votes.
Round 19 kicked off with Collingwood dealing Fremantle's finals chances a massive blow at Subiaco.
Carlton with a touch of vintage Cooter again proved to be Essendon's nemesis with an upset win at the MCG.
At last, some smiles for Hawthorn as Donald McDonald made a claim for the job permanently.
Drama at the SCG, the Jason Ball deliberate, the Corey Jones match winner, the joy for the redoubtable ruse in Archer's 250th.
There was more West Coast woes for reigning Premier Brisbane. Yet again, the Gabba holding no fears for Matera and Co.
And Warren Treadray was imperious against the D's. 12 marks, 6 goals, majestic votes.
I wonder whether you'll get any in this round or not. Brett Kirk, what a season he's having, Tim. And we thought Barry Hall might lead the way at Sydney, but Kirk, 17 votes so far. He gets 33 disposals and 10 clearances, but of course the Kangaroos come back and win.
Luke Power still chipping away on 15. Gallant in West Coast's defeat of Brisbane up at the Gabba had 29 disposals.
And his teammate Simon Black still in it at this stage, the former winner. 13 votes he'll need to poll, you'd think, here. 26 disposals and 5 clearances. We'll see how he fares in round 19.
Round 19. Essendon versus Carlton. Carlton, M. Lappin, one vote. Carlton, S. Caporiali, 2 votes. Carlton N. Stevens, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Collingwood. Collingwood P. Lecuria, 1 vote. Collingwood S. Wowoden, 2 votes. Collingwood L. Davis, 3 votes. Richmond versus Geelong. Geelong S. Johnson, 1 vote. Geelong J. Bartell, 2 votes. Geelong C. Ling, 3 votes. Sydney versus Kangaroos. Kangaroos D. Wells, 1 vote. Sydney B. Hall, 2 votes. Kangaroos D. Harris, 3 votes.
Good work, boys.
St Kilda versus Adelaide. St Kilda H. Black, 1 vote. St Kilda A. Jones, 2 votes. St Kilda R. Harvey, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Melbourne. Port Adelaide C. Corns, 1 vote. Port Adelaide W. Treadray, 2 votes. Port Adelaide B. Laid, 3 votes. Western Bulldogs versus Hawthorn. Hawthorn S. Mitchell, 1 vote. Hawthorn L. Hodge, 2 votes. Western Bulldogs B. Johnson, 3 votes. Brisbane versus West Coast. West Coast C. Judd, 1 vote. Brisbane S. Black, 2 votes. West Coast C. Fletcher, 3 votes.
3 rounds to go in the Brownlow Medal vote count for 2004 as we once again check the top 10 leaderboard. And after that one, Chris Judd back in front by that margin. He has 22 votes ahead of the Adelaide Crows' Mark Ricciuto. Chad Corns well on the hunt. He has 20 votes for Port Adelaide. In fourth spot, Brett Kirk with 17, also with Scott West from the Western Bulldogs. Simon Black has 15 from the Lions, along with his teammate Luke Power. Melbourne's Jeff White. Adam Uze from Melbourne has 14. And Paul Hazelby from the Fremantle Dockers stuck on 13. So after round 19, the leader of the Brownlow Medal is Chris Judd.
And Chris Judd doing it pretty well. He's been there at the top of the tree for most of the night. Let's have a look at his last three rounds. We expect him to bowl pole vaults in round 21 and 22. He's above expectation, actual 22 to our predicted 17.
And Adelaide captain Mark Ricciuto, he's sitting in second spot. And we think there are more votes to come. Let's not forget, he won last year with 22 votes.
And Rob, the tension's building here. It's getting very exciting. Back shortly to count the last three rounds.
Three rounds to go in the Brownlow Medal count for 2004, and she is tight at the top of the leaderboard. Welcome back to Crown, and wherever you may be watching right around Australia, as we check the top five, Chris Judd from the West Coast Eagles has 22, one ahead of Mark Ricciuto from the Adelaide Crows on 21. Chad Corns from Port Adelaide has 20. Brett Kirk from Sydney on 17, along with the Western Bulldogs' Scott West. Time now for round 20.
And coaching vacancies disappeared in round 20. Neil Craig took over at Adelaide, Terry Wallace at Richmond.
Rain and mud were the order of the day at Geelong, but the frigid winds at the MCG had no effect on Jonathan Brown, who excelled against the Hawks.
As Victorians froze, the top end sweltered. Hard to believe it was the same day, same nation. Ah, the joy of it all. It was enough to want to kick up your heels.
Fraser Gehrig did against the Kangas. The runaway G-train steamrolled the Roos, kicking 10 in a scintillating display.
And the Swans pay tribute to club stalwart Wally Jackson in the best possible way.
Well, it's probably down to five contenders, Hutto. How do they look in round 20?
Well, Mark Rusciuto, he's on 21. He's just one off the lead. They defeat Richmond here, the Crows. 28 touches and five clearances. He's in the mix.
Keep your eye on Chad Corns, two off the lead. He has more than 20 possessions in each of the last three games.
And our leader, Chris Judd, on 22 votes. A win over Carlton here for the Eagles. 18 disposals and five clearances. Let's see how they shape up in round 20.
Round 20, Essendon versus Collingwood. Essendon, A. McPhee, one vote. Essendon, J. Hurd, two votes. Essendon, D. Solomon, three votes. Geelong versus Fremantle. Geelong, D. Milburn, one vote. Geelong, S. Johnson, two votes. Geelong, J. Bartell, three votes. Hawthorne versus Brisbane. Brisbane, S. Black, one vote. Brisbane, J. Brown, two votes. Brisbane, M. Pike, three votes. Melbourne versus Sydney. Sydney, A. Goods, one vote. Sydney, M. O'Loughlin, two votes. Sydney, T. Canelli, three votes. Kangaroos versus St Kilda. St Kilda, L. Ball, one vote. St Kilda, F. Gehrig, two votes. St Kilda, N. Revolt, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, B. Laid, one vote. Port Adelaide, G. Wanganeen, two votes. Port Adelaide, B. Montgomery, three votes. Adelaide versus Richmond. Richmond, J. Bowden, one vote. Adelaide, M. Rusciuto, two votes. Adelaide, T. Edwards, three votes. West Coast versus Carlton. West Coast, D. Wirrupunda, one vote. West Coast, D. Cox, two votes. West Coast, C. Judd, three votes.
Chris Judd fights back with a three-voter in round 20. Let's have a look at the top 10 leaderboard. Rusciuto hit the lead, but only for a few seconds. Chris Judd in front with 25. Mark Rusciuto in second spot with 23. Chad Corns with 20. Brett Kirk on 17, as is Scott West from the Western Bulldogs. Over the page, Simon Black on 16, Nick Revolt up to 16 with those three votes, Luke Power has 15, Jeff White 15, and Adam Uze on 14. Two rounds to go on the Brownlow Medal Count of 2004, and your leader for the West Coast Eagles is Chris Judd.
What an intriguing count, Rob. Chris Judd on fire, isn't he? Well, let's have a look at Chad Corns. He's five back, but he does play very well in the last two matches. In fact, we expect him to poll a vote in round 21. But he does do very well also with over 20 possessions in round 22. So he's five back, but certainly not out of it.
No, he's not out of it, and he certainly needs to get votes in the next two rounds to have any chance of winning. But, gee, he'd be very happy with his performance. Played at centre-half back this year. He's done exceptionally well.
Just two rounds to go. Who will be the 2004 Brownlow medalist? Back shortly to find out.
Two rounds to go and it is down to the wire in the Brownlow medal count for 2004. Let's recap the top five before we go to round 21 voting. And it is the West Coast Eagles, Chris Judd. He leads by just two votes from one of last year's winners, Mark Ricciuto from the Adelaide Crows on 23. Looks like a three-way battle now. Chad Corns still well in the hunt from Port Adelaide on 20. And then Brett Kirk from the Sydney Swans on 17, along with Scott West from the Western Bulldogs. Time now for the votes for round 21.
And round 21 saw two flag aspirants trip up. Adelaide celebrated victory over Geelong, while Carlton consoled Melbourne on a third straight defeat.
Bulldog coach in waiting Rodney Eaves sat back and watched his new charges derail North's finals hopes.
Goodbye, guys. Simon Garlick and Matthew Croft, with seven goals between them, went out with a bang.
Through 150 games, Barry Hall had been called many things. But he celebrated his milestone in style, though, and Hollywood was watching. Well, she was there anyway.
And Chris Judd lit up another derby. His two goals were telling. While the Brisbane Lions, challenged early by the Saints, found that extra kick again, Nigel Lappin's season to saver continued.
Well, it is a race in three, so let's check on those three players for this round. We'll start with Chad Corns. He's on 20 votes. He's five off the base. 24 disposals as Port defeat Collingwood at the MCG. 8 marks. He was terrific that night.
Chris Judd, 21 years and 12 days old, would be the youngest since Gavin Wanganeen in 1993. And 23 disposals against Fremantle might stitch it.
And Mark Ricciuto, the Roo, 23 votes. He's two off the pace, 19 disposals, and Adelaide did beat Geelong. Will it be enough to get him some votes? Let's check round 21.
Round 21, Hawthorn versus Richmond. Hawthorn, C. Bateman, one vote. Hawthorn, L. Hodge, two votes. Hawthorn, P. Everett, three votes. Carlton versus Melbourne. Carlton, N. Stevens, one vote. Carlton, A. Koutafidis, two votes. Carlton, D. Teague, three votes. Brisbane versus St Kilda. Brisbane, N. Lappin, one vote. Brisbane, S. Black, two votes. Brisbane, J. Akamanis, three votes. Sydney versus Brisbane. Sydney, J. Bolton, one vote. Sydney, R. O'Keefe, two votes. Sydney, B. Hall, three votes. Collingwood versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, one vote. Port Adelaide, B. Laid, two votes. Port Adelaide, K. Corns, three votes. Western Bulldogs versus Kangaroos. Western Bulldogs, M. Croft, one vote. Kangaroos, D. Wells, two votes. Western Bulldogs, S. West, three votes. Adelaide versus Geelong. Adelaide, M. Clark, one vote. Adelaide, S. Goodwin, two votes. Geelong, C. Ling, three votes. Fremantle versus West Coast. West Coast, D. Kerr, one vote. West Coast, C. Judd, two votes. West Coast, D, Wirrupunda, three votes.
Well, he may not be getting as many votes as we thought, but Warren Treadray's barnstorming season-ending form continued against the Crows.
What a way for Carlton to farewell 2004. The nail-biting win against Collingwood. A particular relief for Brendan Favola, whose earlier indiscretion could have proved costly.
The race for the Coleman medal had a thrilling finish. Fraser Gehrig played hurt and kicked four, setting Matthew Lloyd a seven-goal target to tie for the medal. Lloyd fell one short, but it wasn't for a lack of effort.
And Brisbane turned up for September with a thumping win over the Kangas. But this night was about Anthony Stevens. Respected by all, he said goodbye to the game, surrounded by friends and foes alike.
Well, let's see the votes for round 22. We might know the winner already, but here's Andrew with the last round of votes.
Round 22, Geelong versus Hawthorn. Geelong, P. Koulioritis, one vote. Geelong, S. Johnson, two votes. Geelong, J. Corey, three votes. Collingwood versus Carlton. Collingwood, C. Tarrant, one vote. Carlton, J. Bannister, two votes. Carlton, A. Koutafidis, three votes. St. Kilda versus Fremantle. St. Kilda, N. Revolt, one vote. St. Kilda, N. Del Santo, two votes. St. Kilda, B. Goddard, three votes. Brisbane versus Kangaroos. Brisbane, J. Akamanis, one vote. Brisbane, L. Power, two votes. Brisbane, N. Lappin, three votes. Richmond versus Sydney. Sydney, N. Davis, one vote. Sydney, P. Williams, two votes. Sydney, B. Kirk, three votes. Essendon versus Western Bulldogs. Essendon, M. Lloyd, one vote. Essendon, M. McVeigh, two votes. Western Bulldogs, A. Cooney, three votes. Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, P. Burgoyne, one vote. Port Adelaide, C. Corns, two votes. Port Adelaide, W. Treadray, three votes. West Coast versus Melbourne. West Coast, M. Braun, one vote. West Coast, C. Fletcher, two votes. West Coast, C. Judd, three votes. I have pleasure. Pleasure in declaring Chris Judd the 2004 Brownlow medalist.
Commission Ron Evans to come up and say a few words before we talk to Chris.
Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, the AFL Commission, along with football followers and supporters throughout Australia acknowledge and congratulate the 2004 Brownlow medalist, Chris Judd, and the West Coast Eagles. In his third year, Chris has become the first West Coast Eagle player to win the Brownlow Medal. And when you consider the likes of past champions, such as Peter Matera, Glenn Jakovich, Dean Kemp, Guy McKenna, Ashley McIntosh, Chris Lewis, you'll understand that it is a wonderful achievement from Chris. Chris says, is the product of the Caulfield Grammar School and the TAC Cup, and at age 21 he was drafted just 3 years ago, and this year won All-Australian selection for the first time. Well done to Chris Judge and the West Coast Eagles Football Club.
Chris, if you could just kindly make your way over there, because Adam Goods, Mark Rusciuto and Nathan Buckley are going to sort of jointly present you with the Brownlow Medal for this year. I'd now call on Ron Evans to propose a toast to the Brownlow medalist, Chris Judd.
Ladies and gentlemen, could you be upstanding in toasting our newest Brownlow medalist, Chris Judd? The 2004 AFL Brownlow medalist, Chris Judd.
Thanks, Ron. Thanks to Nathan, to Adam and to Mark. Chris, if you can just drag you away for a few minutes. Congratulations, mate. Was it 21 years and 12 days old?
Yeah, the 21st was a couple of weeks ago, probably 10 days or so. So, yeah, it's only been a couple of weeks, but it's been a good couple of weeks off.
Can you remember your first Brownlow medal? You told me the other day you were a Melbourne fan, and you can remember, what, about 8 years of age, watching Jim Steins win the Brownlow medal back in 1991.
Yeah, I was a Melbourne fan growing up and remember watching Jimmy accept his award and was rapt for him because East Berwick for the Demons, so I was always hoping for him or Gary Lyon or one of the other boys to get up, so I was rapt when Jimmy got up.
You're always a football nut. What did the Brownlow mean to you as a young kid growing up?
Well, it was just a sort of good night to stay up late on a school night and, yeah, just sort of have a look at the season in review. So, you know, it's very humbling to be standing up here and still sort of unbelievable, really.
Take us through your footy career. You started at the ripe old age of seven and you're a Caulfield Grammar product and through to the under-18 competition.
Yeah, I've been flat out since 7 years of age, so it's sort of, I still in my head think I'm about 16 years old, so haven't quite made the transition to AFL football in my head, but yeah, to be standing up here tonight, it's...
I think
it's,
you have now.
Well, with all these cameras around, you'd think so, wouldn't you? But
now, funny about that, because I was reading the other day that you, in fact, don't read the newspapers, you watch very little television, you don't like the publicity. Mate, you're in trouble.
Yeah, I'm in a bit of strife, aren't I? I've black banned the papers.
Not now.
With Rebecca's dress tonight, I've definitely black banned them, so... But,
now I know why.
I've been stressing about the double-sided tape all night, so hopefully... Hopefully it stays good, but I'm going to be in a bit of strife with the media, I reckon.
That is a fair dress, Chris, I'd have to say. Probably the 2001 draft will maybe go down in history as one of the best. You've got Luke Hodge, number one, Luke Ball, number two, Chris Judd, number three. Take us through the process. I know that Hawthorne had the first pick. They were umming and ahhing. You ended up going pick three. What was the story? Was there any reason given in the end why you ended up being pick three? And I know you had shoulder problems at the time.
Yeah, I mean the club's picked. It's sort of comparing apples to oranges. All the players in the draft are different type of players and bring a different sort of thing to each club. So I think each club would be pretty happy with what they've got. And you know, I was fortunate enough to play a bit of footy with Luke Ball, who's had a sensational season this year, and seen a bit of Hodgie play as well. So yeah, I mean, for a while you would have thought we were all from the same family, the way the media talked about us, but you know, fortunately we're all getting on with our footy careers now and would all be pretty happy with where we are.
What about the shoulders? Were they a problem at the time? I know you started your career, you wore some heavy tape. I mean, was it a concern for you?
Well, they were a bit of a problem because they kept popping out. So I had a couple of operations on them before I got drafted.